important. If you have makeup on a full day also, before going to sleep, you should always remove your makeup. That's very important. So today I'm going to show you in three ways. First, you can use a makeup remover like this. This makeup remover is from Sephora. This is the small travel size makeup remover. I got it. You can use any makeup remover. Second, you can use a oil like so. This is a Johnson's baby oil. Normally I prefer to use this one to remove my makeup. And the third one is to use any makeup remover wipes. And also you need some cotton pads like this and some Q-tip to use while removing your eye makeup. So if you have any one of these also, that will be fine. You can remove your makeup by using any one of this. Today I'm going to show you by using this Johnson's baby oil, because this is very mild, and if you don't have your makeup remover also, you can use this baby oil to remove your makeup. And after removing my makeup using this baby oil, I'm going to use this makeup remover wipes to clean the excess later. First, I'm going to start off by removing my eye makeup. First, I'm going to take off my false eyelashes. Then I'm going to take some drops of Johnson's baby oil onto my cotton pads. I'm just going to dab this cotton pad on my eyes for just for 5 to 10 seconds on each eyes. So that it will get easy to melt down your makeup and you can easily remove your makeup from your eyes. Can you see, it's almost took out all the makeup, but still there are some left. So again, I'm going to gently wipe it up with a very light hand. Your eyes again are very sensitive, so do not press it more or do not go harsh with them. Now with the other side of the cotton pad, again I'm going to repeat the same process with my other eye. I'm just going to place this pad for just for 5 to 10 seconds. Go very lightly with your eyes and just lightly remove the makeup. And you see, it's almost took out all the makeup. Now with the other cotton pad, I'm taking some more oil and just going to place it over my eyebrows. I'm doing the same process because I have used the tinted brow gel and it takes a little bit of time to remove this. If you have used any eyebrow pencil, then you can take it off very easily. And with the other side of the pad, I'm just going to take some more oil and applying it to my lip, because I don't like to use makeup wipes onto my lip area. So it's better if you use any cleansing balm or oil while removing then at least your eye makeup and your lip makeup. Now I'm going to clean my full face again in the same manner. cotton pad like this and just pop it outwards. In the cheek area, you always should remove your makeup like this. Also clean your neck areas if you have applied some foundation or any powder. Now I'm going to take one Q-tip and dip this Q-tip onto my oil, just a little bit, and I'm going to remove my eye makeup on my lower lash line. Because sometimes it happens, even though you clean your makeup with a cotton pad, there are still some makeup. So it's better if you use a Q-tip and clean your lower lash makeup. So I have almost removed my makeup. Now I'm going to take one of these makeup wipes just to clean if there is any excess makeup left over. I'm not rubbing it, I'm just gently cleansing, taking out the makeup. Gently rub your eyelashes so that there will not be any mascara. So as you can see, previously I have removed my makeup with the Johnson's baby oil and then after weight remover wipes, and still I got this makeup wipe dirty. So I have almost removed all the makeup. After this process, I believe there is no makeup, but still I always prefer to use a facial cleanser to clean my face. And that's it guys, that's how I've removed my makeup. I hope you like this video. If you like, then please like this video, subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for watching. See you in my next video. Bye.